Hey everyone, it's Mrkikz and welcome to episode 1 of my playthrough of Planet Coaster. And the videos I put out before this one have been sort of let's builds, I suppose, of how to make statues using the art shapes in the game. And I've been making these sort of Mario characters you can see here. And they've been taking up a lot of my time. But if you did come to this channel for more of those Let's Build type things, don't worry, they're not going anywhere. I'm going to keep making those as well. In fact, I've got a Bowser's Castle roller coaster coming up. But that's going to take a little bit of time. So I thought, you know, to fill in the gaps, I would do a Let's Play. Because these have been taking up so much of my time, I've not really had chance to play through the career mode of the game. So I thought, what better way to do it than to do it as a Let's Play and bring you along for the ride so you can watch me build some cool stuff. Because I can build, you know, other stuff other than these characters. You know, I'm not bad. I'm not a bad builder. So if that's something that you're interested in, let's get into it. And yeah, start building things. Oh, I love that music. I love this game. Okay, so avast me hearties, and welcome to Planet Coaster. Shiver those timbers and take charge of this explosive pirate park. Complete ride construction, draw in the crowds, and give your guests a swashbuckling good time. Well, I'm not quite so sure about the swashbuckling good time. That usually leads to peg legs and eye patches, but maybe we'll give them a slightly tamer, less pirate experience. Yeah, you don't want that, kids. You don't want a wooden leg. You don't need that out of life. Raping and pillaging and all these kind of things are great. They're not great. They make for good stories. Don't go out raping and pillaging in real life. Please don't. Please. I'm not encouraging that behavior. I don't condone it. Not one bit. Okay, so this is, like I say, it's like a beginner sort of tutorial type scenario. So it's not really that difficult to get through. It doesn't really go too deep into the management aspects of things or anything. And let's have a look at the objectives for this one. Okay, so yeah, build two rides, bring in an extra guest. We've already kind of got one with the octopus. That's for a bronze star. Shenanigans, build four rides for the silver and blah 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 for 10,000 for the hard. Okay, fine. We can do that. That'd be really easy. It will whiz by. Well, maybe not whiz by, because I'm maybe gonna do a little bit more work than I need to to keep things interesting. This is one of the things I wanted to do with this playthrough. Because I mean, look, you've got a great looking park over here. It's all sort of all these fortresses and skulls and fire and pirate ships, all this good stuff, and just looking beautiful like this game does. Whoop, whoop! Didn't mean to go under the water. I mean, look at that. It's gorgeous. So I want to try and sort of keep to themes while I'm doing this playthrough as much as I can, and try and build, you know, some stuff that is on par with the stuff that's already in the park at least, and just have it look good. Because, I mean, I've not really seen many Let's Plays for this, particularly in the career mode, but I imagine people have got a tendency to just, you know, plop stuff down, put in a minimum of scenery, and, you know, just try and fly through it, whereas I'm going to do it a little bit differently. Now, I'm a slow builder, so I will be speeding up time using my godlike powers, also known as editing, after the fact. So, even if I do take a long time building stuff, it won't be a long time for you. It will, you know, I'll put some nice music up and, you know, you'll see me speed through the building process. So, let's start. Let's get into it. I've been waffling on instead of actually doing stuff. Right. Carousel, no, that's not pirate enough. Neither now. No, we've already got you. Teacups, definitely not. Insanity, you're a bit green-lighty, futuristic-y looking. I don't know whether I'm going to be able to tie this into theme, although, to be fair, I might not be given a choice if I've got to build four. So let's just have a quick look at research and see what we've got actually unlocked later on, because money's not really an issue in the scenario just yet, because it's kind of beginner easy mode. Family ride. We'll go with you, because I don't think I'll be building any coasters in this one. Yes, start please. So that can be going while I'm deciding what I am actually going to build here. I think, even though it's still not really in theme, I think it kind of can. This can be made to look a little bit more oldie worldy. This wild blue ride here, if I sort of change the color scheme up a little bit, it can be made to look a little bit more sort of closer to pirate time, piratey time. Sort of that sort of era, maybe. I'm not even sure what the pirate era was between what years. It was. I mean, maybe they were still around in the late 1800s. And maybe people were throwing together stuff like this. We'll try and figure that out, maybe. So yeah, let's have a change up of the colour scheme here. Let's do it. Get this to be more sort of a... It's not really going to pass as wood, but more sort of woody looking colour. And maybe tone down these colours here to be sort of a bit more muted. Make them look a bit more oldie-worldy maybe. Maybe tone down that yellow a little bit too. Sort of more like some aged parchment type look. Yeah, that'll do. That's muted enough. I'm Zack Snyder in the shit out of this ride. Just suck all the colour out. Okay. Alright. That's good enough for me. So let's slam the entrance down. Now what are we going to do with this queue scenery? Because as I've said, it's not really in keeping with the pirate theme. But maybe I could tell a little story with some of the queue scenery here. I'm just not quite sure what I'm going to have access to at this early stage. Most of the themes, I imagine, will be locked off. I'm not really sure. Well, maybe we can build some sort of stuff around here. So I'll pop the entrance over there just for now, and we'll see how it goes. We can always fiddle with this stuff later. If it doesn't work out, we'll throw the exit around about there. And let's put the queue down. See, I'm thinking of ways. Maybe we can build some sort of, like... Mad Professor's house, maybe, sort of, so he's like mates with the pirates and is playing around tinkering with inventions, and he's built these sort of flying machine-y type things for the pirates. So maybe we can tie in some sort of fairy tale-esque sort of Tudor building here, and we'll stick some sort of crazy stuff out of it and build some scaffolding around it so it looks like this guy's a tinkerer. Maybe we'll do it that way. We'll see how that works out. It might go horribly wrong, but hey, that's half the fun, isn't it, right? Me failing is probably way more entertaining than being successful. So yeah, I don't really like the wobbliness of this. We'll maybe straighten it out a little bit there. Maybe if we can squeeze the house in here, that'd be okay. Hopefully it won't be too tall and sort of mess with the ride. That'll do for now. And we'll just slam this exit in. No, I don't want it to be that colour, please. Oh, could you not? Alright, let's see. Alright, it's a bit wonky, but that'll do. Okay, so as I said, I won't dare torture you with my slow building, so let's use some of my godlike power and speed up time a little bit. Wait a minute, wait, before I do that, before I leave you, I'll just lock off time so it doesn't get dark while I'm building. And you can see everything. Okay, so, godlike powers, activate!
4 hours later.
Yeah, I got a little bit carried away there. Yeah, but I think I achieved what I set out to achieve there, which was to kind of make it look like a mad professor's house. Well, the best I could. I put this little burning crashed fly machine into the side here. I built all the scaffolding and the cranes and things outside to make it look like some sort of, you know, workshoppy type thing. I've got this boat poking out here. I'll let you decide how that managed to get there. So yeah, let's open her up to the public. I think I did a bit of testing while I was building that, just to see whether it would collide with anything, and it was all okay. So yeah, let's get some people riding it, and hopefully that should be our first star. I think that'll be the bronze star after a little while, once people have gone on it, and yeah, the queue rating's great and all that sort of stuff. And oh yeah, our research projects should be all done as well now. And it's a whirly rig. Nice, nice. We've got some actual pirate theme stuff to work on now. So yeah, all those people are piling in now. They'll be nice and happy with all the queue scenery and things like that, and it should work out. I also built a couple of benches down here. Now this space here, I'm thinking of filling with some toilet blocks or something like that. I think that's probably best. Maybe put a drink shop and a toilet block down there, and maybe try and theme it the same sort of thing here. To make it look like maybe a shed or something. I'll see about that. Or some sort of outdoor workshop, metalworky type place, something like that. Maybe that would work out. I should maybe tar the rock put up a little bit. It's looking a bit sad next to this one now. It's looking a bit minimalist. It doesn't really need much doing to it, and as far as I can see, yeah, the scenery rating's at 73%, so I could just chuck maybe a fountain section down here in the front, and that'd probably do it. It'd probably bring it up to 100, and then that'll keep all the guests nice and happy. It'll bring in all the moolah, all the dollary doos, and yeah, it should help us out. And then all there is to do is really just build some more rides. Of course, I'll go over the top with those as well. So yeah, I'll see about that one. As for the whirly rig, ooh, hello. There we go. I've got the bronze star. So yeah, we need another 2 more rides now, I think, to get the, yeah. How many guests have we got now? All right, okay. All right, yeah, we've got to attract 800 guests, and I think the other 2 rides should do that pretty easily. As I say, this one's fairly easy scenario. It's only taken so long because I take so long building. So yeah. I think I'll go back into super speedy fast time. I can't remember what I called it the last time. It's been forever. Yeah, and I'll get building some more, and we'll sort all of this out, and then see what to do with the whirly rig. Okay. We're back. Everything's been done. I made a couple of alterations over here to the house. I threw up some, you know, just points of detail, got an exploding chimney up there, and some sort of metallic confetti flying out here with some sparks. I changed the colours of the windows, and yeah, that was about it for that one. And along here, we've built this little sort of workshoppy outhouse type, shed type building. And, you know, just put a sort of patched up roof here with some more smoke coming out just to give the riders the idea that they might just fall off and crash into stuff, as would the sort of, you know, flying machine crashed into the side of the building there. And yeah, I think it looks okay. I think it looks quite nice. Obviously, we've got this sort of big empty space back here, which is, you know, always going to make it look a bit iffy. But we've added these fountains to the Roctopus here and built this little wall around the outside. And just, you know, a little boat here and some rocks for some flavour. So I'm quite happy with this area now. And I think we can move on to building the whirly rig now. Yeah, I think that's probably going to be fun as well. I've not really got an idea of what to do with it. Maybe we could build it into some sort of like little island in the middle of a sort of a lake. If we build some sort of like lake around here somewhere, that could be quite nice. And we'd be able to border off this with some maybe some shops and stuff, so it doesn't look quite so bare on this left side here. So yeah, I think that's probably the best course of action with the old whirly rig. I think I'm sort of got enough guests to beat the I've got enough guests to beat the second section. It's already ticked off. It's just I need the other two rides going down. So basically, once I've plopped the next two rides down, I think that'll be level done. So yeah, because I've spent so long doing all of this for no reason, it's complete overkill. But yeah, that's what I'm here to do. As again, as I've already said, I'm here to make it look nice and maybe, you know, show you some unconventional building methods. I realized as I was building this one here that I've been a bit of an idiot while building this one. It's been a while since I've actually played around with the building pieces. So I've kind of forgotten some of the tips and tricks and methods that I used to use, basically, and then just kind of remembered it while building this, sort of separating pieces from buildings and things like that I'd completely forgotten about. So yeah, I learned a couple of things. I'm warming up now. So yeah, let's get into building the whirly rig in super fast speed. And then I won't even talk about the whirly rig. I'll talk about it all at the end once I've done everything. I think I'll plop down maybe Insanity as well and do it all as one big sort of burst, and then we'll talk about it at the end once I've won the game. I think that's probably the best method. So yeah, see you on the other side. Godlike powers, activate! And would you look at that? We've got gold, baby. Well, we got silver, baby. I got the gold earlier on. Now I've got 3 stars. That's what counts. It's all done. It's all complete. Yeah, the speedy time. When I was building the carousel, I earned the gold then. And that was just the second thing of the silver achievement, was me building 2 more rides. So yeah, whatever. Semantics. Who cares? So yeah, here's the finished park. Let me just open up the whirly rig and I'll take you on a little tour in a speed that you can actually see what the hell's going on. I'm sorry if the other one was a bit erratic. I remember doing a lot of swoopy movements with the camera. A lot of swoopy time. So I'm sorry about that. But here you can see it in all its glory. So yeah, I did what I said I would. I built this little rocky island here for the whirly rig and this little lake. Don't ask me how the galleon got there, that's for another day. And yeah, put this little sort of pirate battle down. I was getting I'm a bit tired now, guys. It's been like 8 hours, so I was gonna build some big spectacular thing, but I got a bit lazy towards the end, so you know, sorry about that. But yeah, put some palm trees down to make it look a bit more tropical around the sort of beachiness. Little guy in a boat there, a little lookout and some wreckage. So yeah, it's I think it looks quite nice for what it is. And and yeah, I thought I'd build this sort of big barrel-y tower. I'm not really sure what it is, but I wanted something that looked sort of hodgepodge and not together. And yeah, while I was doing that, I got a bit lazy again and just built a carousel instead of putting Insanity down. I did have a really cool idea for Insanity, but because I'm getting a bit tired, I didn't really do it. But I was going to have this sort of cave where there were 2 pirate ships, one's upside down on the ceiling, and another is sort of right side up on the floor. And no matter where you were on Insanity, there's always like a right side up pirate ship, and it'd feel a bit weird. Like whatever direction you were facing seemed like the right way up. But as I say, it would have taken a long time and I've been at it for hours, so I kind of copped out and put the carousel down. But yeah, this tower's barrel tower type thing. I think it's really nice. It's sort of hodgepodge. It kind of looks like the mad professor guy who lives here kind of built it out of the wreckage of the sort of ship you can see in the back there. And I think that's kind of a nice touch to bridge the gap between the sort of Tudor-esque sort of architecture here and the sort of beach over on the right. I thought that was a nice touch. I thought it kind of seemed right. I was sort of, you know, I didn't really know how to sort of do that and how to bridge the 2 areas together, but I think it worked out in the end. I was going to build some sort of beach huts around here and stuff, but you know, I'm already done. I've already gone OTT. I'm not going mega OTT and filling the entire park. So yeah, I wasn't a big fan of filling the whole park up. I was kind of considering it. And I built this big sort of mountain range here to sort of lock off this section, because no, I was not going to be doing any more building. That was my way of saying no, not going to do any more. So yeah, that's the park done. I really hope you enjoyed it and as much as I enjoyed building it. And yeah, if you enjoyed it and you're ready for the next episode, then please hit subscribe to see me build more crazy things and go over the top in more episodes of this Let's Play. And keep an eye out for my Let's Builds for more sort of creative things. But yeah, that's all for now, guys. Thanks very much for watching. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one.